Yo, CPA Strength here. After owning my own business for three years owning my own business, guess what? I'm still here. And that's the main thing. I'm still here. I just looked at the one after I was owning for like a couple months, then the first year, then the second year. So this is owning my own business after 3 years. Would I do it again? Am I happy I started my own business? Yes, by all means. And I really think the main thing is you cannot predict what is gonna happen. I thought I was prepared, and I said this pretty much in the first year installment, second year installment, like you cannot predict what is gonna happen. You gotta prepare as best you can and just hope you make it. Huge things happened since the last video. So for 3 years, I had a lease at that office that where most of my other videos were at. And now I'm in my house, my YouTube studio house, which I'm gonna start using more. And that actually, the YouTube has turned into, you know, a decent part of my business. I don't necessarily make a lot of money from the YouTube, but I get a sense of fulfillment that I'm helping people with my accounting for beginners, and I have other ideas for the YouTubes. So owning my own business is actually, you know, growing my YouTube channel as well. I know one of my goals last year was to get out of that office and stop living with my dad, and now I have a nice big house. One of the things that really happened, I guess probably the biggest thing, was I had a client that was my biggest client, and kind of had a mutual agreement that I would start going into their office every day. And it's still a little raw. This is actually I worked there for 3 months. And I still had my other stuff. Like, they were paying me to my business still. So I still had my business. I still had all my other clients, but this was my biggest client, and I still had my YouTube. Except that it was so just draining that I couldn't do anything else after that job. And it's actually, I worked there for 3 months, and we parted ways 2 weeks ago. And I will never say anything, you know, I need to keep it professional, and I'll never say anything negative about a client of mine or anything, except, you know, we parted ways. And I'll go into it more, I mean, when it's not so raw for me. You know, maybe next year or something. So, you know, your boy's kind of scrambling now. I do have my own business, and I'm working out of my own house now, so it's a whole new set of things. But yeah, owning my own business after 3 years, like I kind of went back to the corporate lifestyle, and that was just a mistake. Like, I need to be on my own now. I just can't go back to that. Like I found myself, you know, looking at the clock again. It's almost over. Just looking at the clock, feeling like I didn't really do anything for the day. A bunch of corporate da-da-da, like, felt like I was just in a hamster wheel. And yeah, I was making good money for me. I was making real good money for me. And I've never made so much money for me. It was twice as much as I've ever made in my life. But you know what? I just wasn't happy. And I've gone back and forth with should I have parted ways with that client or not? And, you know, I'm gonna make it. I'm a hustler, I'm a grinder. It's really all I know is to hustle and grind and be the underdog. And so I was in a weird space just getting that paycheck, that big paycheck every week, and it was just a weird space for me. So I'm here to say, you know, when I look at this for next year, owning my own business for 4 years, I'll be like, yeah, I mean, I remember that. Because I looked at my other ones and, you know, the first year I had like two, I was like a third of the way to making the money. I'm kind of in a similar situation now where I'm not making enough money, but I know how it goes where when tax season comes around, that's when I'll pick up new clients. And you know, I'm feeling a lot better just making this video and stuff, because, and you know, I hope I can motivate. I want to motivate people to follow their dreams, and it's not always going to be easy, and there's going to be setbacks and everything like that. Like, you know, where it's like some people think success is just a straight line, where success is really like all the way around and everything like that. But yeah, I'm still a licensed CPA and I got options. I got an old lady now too, which, oh, I really care about a lot. And LBZ, she's like, and she's really been here for me the past couple months through everything. And I couldn't, love you a lot, LB. Thanks a lot for being there for me in the past couple months. I couldn't have done this without you, without your support and understanding. LB will be on the channel soon sometime, and well, anyways, owning my own business after 3 years. What? I coached Little League baseball during tax season, which I don't know if I could do. Well, I definitely can't do it this year because I need to make more revenue, but my income was good last year, and it just really wiped me out, and I couldn't really grow the business. But yeah, I coached, you know, owning my own business, I guess it gave me the flexibility to say, hey, I want to coach Little League Baseball, so I'm going to coach Little League Baseball. So I coached nine and 10-year-olds Little League Baseball last year from owning my own business. Let's see, am I glad I did it? Yes. It's one of the best things I've ever done. Would I do it again? Yes. If you're thinking about, just do it, man. Just do it. You know, you're gonna watch, you know, you're probably watching other videos on like owning my own business and should I own my own business and should I do it or whatever. And I think, you know, most of everyone's gonna say it's scary, but it's a learning experience. And I mean, sometimes you just gotta jump and grow wings on the way down. Anyways, I knew what I was going back to. I knew I was going back to what LBZ said. She's like, honey, you got the wind knocked out of your sails. Cause I'm like, the past couple weeks I've been going back and forth. I shouldn't have parted ways with that client. What am I gonna do now? Now I got bills, I can't afford my bills, I'm a loser, I'm this, you know, and I've just had no energy, I've been all over the place with what my next move is. But slowly I'm getting more and more wind in my sails. And you know, slowly I'm getting more wind in my sails. So who knows where I'm gonna be after next year, but I can guarantee I'm gonna still be around. Another thing in my head, another thing I just thought of too, owning my own business, and I just started with, you know, growing the YouTube channel is part of owning my own business. It's that, you know, with baseball, with coaching baseball and tax season, I just didn't have any extra bandwidth for the YouTube channel. I went about 200 straight days of uploading and then just stopped for about 7 months. After baseball season, I was still coaching baseball, moved in, closed my old office, moved into my house office studio, and started working at this new job, which was insane, stressful, and everything for me. So I left YouTube for 7 months, and I lost all that momentum, and I wish I didn't do that, but I did. You know, I noticed I've been posting again recently, and a lot of my daily watchers, I had, you know, a good chunk of daily watchers before that would watch all my videos, and they're not, you know, very few have come back, and I totally understand. I totally understand. I left him in the dark, but you know what? I'm back now. I'm not. This is what I love, and I'm not leaving again. But I know, you know, you gotta show it with your actions more than your words. So I'm here to do that. And another thing I learned with, you know, owning my own business and doing this and doing that is that I'm not, to me, and I think you'll hear from a lot of other people, that making a lot of money means nothing if you're unhappy. And that was true for me. Also, you're never gonna be really truly successful unless you're passionate about your work. You know, if you can't wait to get up, you know, and get going, which I'm getting back to that now. So owning my own business and kind of figuring out which ways I want to get my revenue stream from is, you know, I'm passionate about that. And I guess if I don't get monetarily rich, I will be rich from my happiness. I also suffer with debilitating anxiety, debilitating depression. I am a drug addict, alcoholic, 5.5 years sober from that. And so I deal with a lot of things, and I just want to keep pushing forward. Anyways, I'm going to end it. This was kind of an all over the place, but it is what I thought, and owning my own business for 3 years. And I guess the thing is, yeah, I've been able to pay my own bills, make my own way, rent my own house. And I'm still here, and that's another thing. When the dust settles, I'm gonna still be here. I'm 41 years old. I grew up eating Body Bodies, which was the lamest welfare cereal ever. So I've been hustling, grinding forever. And I'll see you next year for owning my own business after 4 years. Anyways, this is CPA Strength, and I'm out for now. Deuces.